Earlier this year, the company Sophie has announced that they will go public. But the coolest part is, they will give their amateur investors the opportunity to buy shares before they actually go public. And this breaks a tradition on Wall Street. Is this something for you as an investor to be looking out for as well? And that is the question I would like to discuss with you in today's video. My name is Lucas, and as an investor from XLWealth.com, I'm always interested in sharing my ideas on personal finance, investing, and real estate. Before we go into the whole idea of buying shares before the company goes public, as an amateur investor, the first question to mention here is, what kind of a company is Sophie actually? Well, Sophie is the combination of the words social finance, based in San Francisco, and is an online provider of student loans, home mortgages, personal loans, credit cards, and cryptocurrency trading and wealth management services. The company was founded back in 2011 to provide student loan refinancing for millennials. Now, why was this a great market to be at? Well, you gotta see it like this. There were over $1.2 trillion of student loans in the US. And back then, they had a great management team that had lots of knowledge of the industry. And the best position they had was the money that they took from people who were going to be highly educated and not rich yet. So those are the best people because they will be getting a good job and a good pay. And these people would graduate with a nice degree and the only thing what they would do is they would pay off their loans with a very steady once they get a job. And that is the market that Sophie took care of very, very intelligently. Now the company had some setbacks and back in 2019 they got back on track again and now they're on fire. The company has been estimated around $8.7 billion, whereas just last year and back in 2020 they were only estimated at $5.7 billion. So yeah, they're growing, absolutely. Is Sophie a good purchase? As mentioned before, the company has an estimate of $8.7 billion valuation and is projecting to grow its membership and the revenue at least at a pretty rapid rate. Last year, Sophie purchased the fintech Galileo, a platform that helps other fintech carry out front and back end functions such as account setup, account funding, direct deposit, among other functions. Now, the whole idea with all of these products is for Sophie to create a financial service productivity loop, whereas customers that come to the company for one product, of course, will end up with Sophie as their other financial needs as well. And the more products that customers purchase from Sophie, the more profitable the company becomes. And because there's less spend required on customer acquisition. For example, a customer that signs up for Sophie money cash management product and then a personal loan becomes much more profitable than with just either of the one. Or, you know, if you have two different people sign up for only one product. So with the financial services productivity loop strategy in mind, Sophie CEO Anthony Noto really sees two big opportunities. And the first one is it's the top 10 legacy banks in the US hold more than 500 million US customers, or actually consumer bank accounts. Now, Noto believes that the company will be able to continue to create more differentiated product to lure these legacy bank customers to their own platform. And the other opportunity that Noto sees in regard to the 50% of US bank accounts being held to smaller financial institutions is that it's in this area Noto sees a B2B, a business-to-business play, and believes that Galileo and Sophie products can help these institutions create a better product and services. The moment the CEO sees all these opportunities and their companies is delivering, this actually just means only one thing. This is a great growth opportunity. Is Sophie capitalizing? For Sophie to succeed in its strategy, it needs to grow members, show that it's cross-selling products to members, and it's also exhibit growth of Galileo. Now, in terms of membership, the company is doing well with 1.7 million members at the end of 2020. And expectations is that it will grow a membership to 3 million by the end of this year. The company also is seeing success in its cross-selling efforts, with 65% of its home loans coming from existing members. Recently, Sophie announced that it has planned to offer a car loan refinancing option for its members because customers just demand that, and the high car loan balances, and the company sees that it's a good amongst its existing members. It's a good thing to see that a company can actually roll out new products quickly considering its strategy. Now, Sophie has big plans for Galileo. Clients of Galileo include other big fintech like Robinhood, Revolut, Monzo, and Current. And Galileo also plans to explore international opportunities in Latin America and Asia. So I'm also excited to see what is going to happen in this platform, because they are most likely going to generate some revenue over 900 million by 2025. And since you stayed until the end, I would like to share with you my ideas of this company, because will it meet the expectations? The company has a valuation of $8.7 billion, and it also has quite some aspirations. The company is projecting adjusted net revenue of $3.7 billion by 2025. And Sophie also recently acquired the tiny Golden Pacific Bancorp, which will accelerate its goal of achieving a bank charter. Now, the company expects the bank charter to significantly streamline operations very soon. This just means that all the purchases they are making are all meant for growth. And Sophie expects to be the first profitable starting from 2023 and currently trades around $17 per share. Investors are going to watch how the company performs relatively to its projections. And if it can hit, you know, its goals, the stock should be able to grow very quickly. I'm guessing that the CEO Noto is well acquainted with the beat and raise game that the public companies play on Wall Street. If Noto can report faster than its expected growth each quarter again and raise the guidance Sophie provides analysts, then I'll tell you this, then I expect its public traded shares to keep rising and rising. There are many risks that could keep that from happening, but based on what I know now, I'm betting that Sophie will manage them just finely. And with that, I would like to thank you for watching today's video. I'll see you next time. Happy investing. Bye-bye.